Since 2011, Chesapeake College has honored and recognized members of our local community who've offered great service both to our communities but also to the college. This year, we're recognizing a group that we actually work with on the college, the Multicultural Advisory Committee, composed of members of our local educational, religious, civic, and business communities that have served on this committee and provided such support for our students as well as for the communities we serve on the Mid Shore. This year in particular, the committee is working on raising funds to further endow the J.H.C. Gibson Memorial Scholarship, a scholarship program that assists our students with the purchase of books in particular. This year, please join me in recognizing the Multicultural Advisory Committee and its work with the J.C. Gibson Memorial Scholarship. Thank you.
The Multicultural Advisory Committee is a committee consisting of community leaders such as pastors, educators, volunteers, people that really believe in the community, and they were brought together over 20 years ago to help support the college's mission of helping diverse backgrounds as far as students. The committee's job or main focus is to really open up doors of understanding and opportunities for communities that may not think that higher education is for them. And so the Multicultural Committee has been a great partner to the college in that way.
Given the invitation to join MAC, I joined hands down, you know, without a doubt, no reservation. As, you know, a minority growing up in Talbot County, you know, there were a lot of limitations on success or things, you know, that I felt like I could do. I couldn't afford to go to college. You know, I've met some great people in my life that, you know, have helped me along the way. So I do feel like, you know, it's my civic duty to do the same, and MAC definitely, you know, provides that platform. And it's all about expanding the culture. The benefit of community leaders and activists such as myself and obviously, you know, employees of Chesapeake College, it creates a certain synergy, especially given the times that we're living in now, racial divide, societal issues, you know, however you want to name it. I definitely feel like Black history should have always been celebrated. MAC has put on this Black History Luncheon. People are visual, so when they see these Black History Luncheons, they see these keynote speakers that exude success. The young man, Jalen Mooney, I watched him grow up. To see that, it inspires other people. So in more ways than one, things like this, the Black History Luncheon, they inspire other people to be great. So I do feel like MAC is actually creating, they're fostering environment to where as though success is imminent.
Mr. Gibson, when he was an employee here at Chesapeake College, his mission, really aside from his job, was to help students. If a student didn't have enough money in the cafeteria, he would help pay lunch. If they were short on their books, he would help them in any way. So shortly after he passed, his family started a scholarship in his honor to continue his passion for helping students, to empower students. And it connected with the mission of the Multicultural Advisory Committee to help underrepresented communities, and that's why we adopted and funded the J.C. Gibson Scholarship Fund. The J.C. Gibson Memorial Scholarship really helps students take care of their books and their other supplies. Education is so expensive and costs are rising steadily. A lot of students get money to pay for their tuition, but then there's the books, there are the fees, there are the laptops, there are other kind of materials that students may not be able to afford. And so the J.C. Gibson Scholarship takes care of that. And we have awarded thousands and thousands of dollars since 1995 to help all types of students in this way.
After I graduated high school, I went to Towson University, and when I was there, my mom passed away, so that kind of threw me off my balance. And after a couple years, I had to take a hiatus from school after that. But after a couple years, I just decided I want to go back to school, and so I just decided to start at Chesapeake again. And I mean, this is somewhere I can get my start learning, so this is where I've kind of revived my love for learning and just remembered how fun it is to go to school. This year's semester, I plan on graduating from Chesapeake, and I want to transfer to a four-year university where I plan to major in secondary education in history and political science with a minor in communication. And I'm excited because I can't wait to hit the ground running and finish school because I want to give back to the community like so many have to me. And I want to be a teacher so I can help educate the next generation. My main goal is to be the first Black senator in Maryland. The J.C. Gibson Scholarship helped me have enough money to pay for my textbooks and my materials for my classes this year. And that was just a nice relief during the pandemic when things aren't so financially stable. Scholarships are important because they provide a pathway for students who might not necessarily see how they can afford to go to college or pay for their materials outright. I would just want to say thank you to the providers of the J.C. Gibson Scholarship, because I'm going to use this money for the right way, and I'm going to make sure that this semester I got to put in the extra effort a little bit more to make sure my grades are on top, because someone else is supporting me. And I don't want this money to go to waste when it could have went to somebody else who put it to better use. So I'm going to make sure I get the most use out of it and use it to help me succeed.
I actually started Chesapeake College in the year 2000, right after I graduated from high school. I started out, I was a little bit undecided on going for a teaching degree. So I just came in and I enrolled into liberal arts. I came here for about, I would say, a year before I had to quit due to transportation issues. And eventually it brought me back here 2 years ago. Right now the degree I'm pursuing is early childhood education / special education teacher. And that's actually what I do now. I'm a special education instructional assistant. So I wanted to go ahead and get the degree while I'm actually doing the job. Chesapeake College is actually helping me pursue that goal because, like, as of right now, I'm taking up a course, early childhood development and behavior, and those are the type of issues that and problems that I'm working with now. So while going to college and working with those students, it helps me to teach them, and not only that, while I'm learning along the way. It's not easy balancing college, working a full-time job and a part-time job while parenting two teenagers. I wasn't even thinking about I had to pay for books. All I was focusing on is to pay for my class and get started. And after learning to become a recipient, I'm very appreciative because that helped me to take a burden off of not actually taking on another payment for books. I would just like to say thank you with the biggest smile on my face that's underneath this mask, because it helped me to focus on school and not worry about purchasing books or purchasing any other equipment to finish and go ahead and work towards my teaching career.
To me, no matter who you are or where you are in life, like, Chesapeake offers a way for success. It gives you the keys and the tools. Even in later age at 37, I just took the MHIC exam to start my own construction company, Cardinal Construction. Coming back at 37, Chesapeake was still there to offer a new set of training, right? So, you know, with that being said, it's timeless. Chesapeake has always been that staple for success in the Mitchell. I'm seeing more minorities get skilled trades, some type of certifications or some type of education. They successfully complete the course of study at Chesapeake and they move on. I do feel like MAC has created that platform. You know, with that synergy that I spoke on earlier, that creates it fosters a certain culture within Chesapeake College that it helps minorities excel. I believe that that's due in part, you know, to MAC's efforts.
The J.C. Gibson Scholarship to us is a living legacy, because what it does, it funds dreams, it funds aspirations, and once we are gone, it's a memorial scholarship, so it doesn't matter who's involved in it, who's in charge, it will be a lasting legacy to empowerment, to education, to opening doors for opportunities for all types of students. So that's what the J.C. Gibson Memorial Scholarship means to not only to the college, the Multicultural Advisory Committee, but to also the students that have benefited from it.